Now that's got to be a wig.
I look like your boyfriend from high school.
In the face of grace, heart full of darkness, spotlight on my face. There was love all around me, but I was looking for the best. Thank God it never found me, would have been the end.
But these goldens, oh, I just, oh.
What's that?
And he... This guy's not available though. He's
no, not
available. Look at these guys. Is this an Akita here with this fluffy part?
She's part Akita, probably.
Oh.
We got clippings that we'll figure out something.
Mitzi's available. And Roxy's available. Roxy! Hey! Roxy! Oh. Oh, I'm so tempted. I love that color fur. It's like caramel. Sasha is a blue heeler. Oh, I can tell by your markings.
Crisis nurseries, domestic violence shelters. We go to the YWCA here, the juvenile detention facility, the women's shelter. So,
because sometimes the abuse can relate to an animal much faster than a human.
They open up and they start trusting and getting attachment, and the dogs teach them empathy, respect, tolerance. That's what our program is all about.
Because sometimes the humans are abusive, but the animals are loving.
They trust.
Yes.
And she will pull me up the stairs to go upstairs. A couple of things that I've done for post-traumatic stress syndrome people is to teach the dog to be calm. And the calmness of the dog, he'll know, or she, the dog will know, when the man or the woman is having PTS, which is a very hyperventilating, not being able to go in crowds of people. And the dog is going to recognize this and come over and try to defuse the situation by maybe sitting quietly and putting her head on that person's lap.